I'm very excited to be here today with Brett Porter from Porter Affordable Pumps with an amazing piece of engineering. So this little piece of beautiful, long-lasting, strong engineering uses water to pump water with specs that leave many of our electric pumps for dead. It will pump water to nearly a 400 metre head, using nothing but water as the power source and water as the lubricant source. It is nearly three times the potential head pressure of some of the best pumps that are on the market, with very few moving pieces and a quality of engineering that we believe will outlast us, and that our children will be still gaining the benefits from. The point is, we are not using non-renewables, we're not getting a monthly bill, we are not paying out money continually to somebody else.
What I like so much about these pumps are, and what's special about them, is that they're self-regulating and self-priming. So as the water flows down, if you're getting into a drier period of time, the pump just slows down to that flow. And then if the stream picks up, when you get a rain event, the pump just picks up automatically. But also, if someone is irrigating upstream and stealing all your water, the pump will just stall and wait for the flow to pick up again, and off she goes again. And no other pumps can do that on the market at this stage. We call this pump a pressure amplifier or a perpetual piston pump. One of the most unique things about this pump is it works off free energy. It works off gravity, water and gravity. So no electricity, no fuel needed for this pump to drive it. So you can put this pump anywhere, in any location, as long as you've got fall and flowing water, and it will pump water for you. The difference between this pump and a ram pump is a ram pump works off velocity running down the drive pipe. So you've got water racing down a drive pipe on a fall, so it's picking up speed. And once it gets to a certain velocity or a certain speed, it slams the valve shut. And that slamming the valve shut, which creates pressure in the dome, which pushes that water out through the check valve and up through your delivery line. So infinite, there's an infinite happening. So that hitting is an infinite action. So a lot of pumps or ram pumps were made in the past very strong, very heavy, to try and overcome that infinite, that destructive force, because they were breaking. Whereas this one here is a pressure amplifier, it's very soft, so it only gradually works. So there's no great strain on the pumps. The only strain that we do have is when you're pumping to higher heads, because you've got pressure coming back into the pump and the piston's got to overcome that pressure as well. One of the things through all the testing I've done with this pump, in this pump chamber, I've had up to 630 psi of pressure inside this pump chamber. That equates to 400 metres of vertical lift that this pump can do. Pumps at 120 metres struggle anything over that because of the pressure in your delivery lines. It's just so great. Even the twin impeller firefighters have a lot of trouble pumping those high heads. They use a lot of fuel and they don't last long. A couple of years and you've got to replace them. One of the main things about the design of this pump, and I've put a lot of time and effort into it, I do not like this idea of a throwaway society. I've designed this pump that it will last a lifetime and even pass it on to your kids. That's how long I believe these things will go for. Righto, we'll just describe the pump, some of the parts and how it actually works. So you have a supply pipe, or in the old terms, a drive pipe, which is this one here that's coming down from your fall, your waterfall, or upstream. So it's coming into the bottom of the pump. This water here that's coming in is a low pressure water. Goes into the bottom of the base, expands the tire, and the tire is acting like a diaphragm or a big piston. So you've got low pressure pushing a big piston, which pushes a smaller piston, which creates higher pressure. So we're converting low pressure through a ratio, gear ratio, to high pressure, which enables us to pump higher heads. Piston pumps have always been the best for pumping higher pressures. That's why we have motor cars with pistons in them. As the water flows in, this whole top section lifts up. The tire is expanding, this lifts this up. As that's lifting up, it's actually pushing water out through the delivery line, which goes up to your tank or your dam. So it goes to a higher head. When this pump drops back down by gravity, it's sucking in water back into the pump chamber for the next upward stroke. So that's how simple the whole process is. And the simplicity even goes in further on with the actual maintenance of the pump. So all we need to do is just take off your bore with your 8 screws, you take off your piston head, your, what we call a hat, our spacers, and this whole top section comes off. We turn him over and we can see there's a plate in here where we take 4 screws out and we can undo the rod seals. There's 3 rod seals on that. Take them out, put your new ones in, put the 4 screws back in with the disc, slide it back over your shaft again. Put the, there's a washer in the bottom of it that's very important with the pump because it stops this hat from punching into the plastic. Then we just replace the spacers again, and this is allows for different stroke lengths by the spacers. Put the hat back on, and then we screw a disc and the piston with the seal. Again, because this is a smaller piston, it's going to create a lot more higher pressure. So we screw it in so it allows it to stop a bit of the leakage, the pressure leaking through the thread seal, the thread.
That was beautiful.
And then we put the ball back on and we tighten it down with the wing nuts. And your pump's ready to go again.